Greetings in our Savior's name. This is Tuesday of Holy Week, and for our devotional time this week, we have moved into the narthex and are considering the four stained glass windows found in our narthex. Yesterday, we looked at the faith window you see behind me here, and today we will look at the love window. Let us make our beginning. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Amen. The reading I've chosen for the love window comes to us from John chapter 15. This is my commandment, that you will love one another as I have loved you. Greater love has no one than this, that someone lay down his life for his friends. You are my friends if you do what I command you. No longer do I call you servants, for the servant does not know what his master is doing, but I have called you friends. For all that I have heard from my Father, I have made known to you. You did not choose me, but I chose you, and appointed you, that you should go and bear fruit, and that your fruit should abide, so that whatever you ask the Father in my name, he may give it to you. These things I command you, that you love one another. My dear friends in Christ, as we consider the love window behind me, Jesus says that the epitome of love, the very pinnacle of love, is that one would lay down his life for his friends. Now, certainly that is exactly what our love window is focused upon. If you see the love window, you'll notice that we have the Lamb, who of course is the Lamb of God, Jesus Christ, who gives his life for the life of the world. But at the very top, you notice that there's a hand, and it's pointing downward, reminding us that God is the one who sends Jesus. As John 3 tells us, for God so loved the world that he gave his only begotten Son. God the Father gives his Son, and the Son, the Lamb of God, gives his life, demonstrating his love for the world. Jesus commands that we love one another as he has loved us. It is hard to be that sacrificial. It is hard to be that self-giving. But he certainly sets the example for us on what love means, on how we should love one another. It is very hard to do in these times, especially when so much uncertainty and fear fills our lives. Generating love for one another can be very difficult. My guess is that over the last couple weeks and in the few weeks to come when we are in isolation, we are going to become impatient with one another within the household. It will be hard to love one another when you've been cooped up together for so long. In those moments, may I remind you to look to Christ for his love, for his self-giving love, his sacrificial love, his love like no other. We are called to love one another as he has loved us by laying down his life. The Lamb of God sacrificed for the world. That is love, and it's the love we're called to. A couple of additional readings I have for you this morning. The first is the very familiar passage you've probably heard read at almost every Christian wedding you've ever been to, from 1 Corinthians 13, and it really expresses the idea of all that love means. It doesn't boast, it's not proud, it takes no joy in wrongdoing. That's love, and it's described well in 1 Corinthians 13, and it's the greatest thing. It's the greatest thing for us, it's the greatest thing we need. That love can manifest itself in your family right now as you're isolated together at home. But it can also manifest itself through prayer to the world outside. Right now, the best way we can express love for the world outside is to pray for them. To pray for those who are sick, to pray for those who are first responders, to pray for those who are essential and need to go to work, to pray for all. Prayer is a great expression of love right now. The second reading I have for you comes to us from 1 John chapter 4, and it begins, "Beloved, let us love one another, for love is from God." We love one another because that is who God has made us to be. That is who God has saved us to be in Jesus Christ. The great example of Jesus in his self-sacrificing love is that we would be engendered and made able to love one another. Would you pray with me? Gracious Heavenly Father, we give you thanks that you loved us enough to send your Son, Jesus Christ, to be our Savior, to be the Lamb of God who gives his life for the life of the world. We ask that his love might move us, that we too might love one another, that we might love those within our own households, even as our patience grows thin and as our isolation grows long. We pray also that you would move us to love those outside of our households through the gift of prayer, lifting them up with holy hands to him who is able to answer all their needs. May this act of love be an everyday part of our lives. Watch over us through our time of isolation and separation. Be with us in this Holy Week as we keep our eyes focused upon he who was crucified and risen, that we might have eternal life. It is indeed in Jesus' name we pray. Amen. The peace of the Lord be with you always. Amen.